For video cassette information about this program, please write to this address.
This is PBS.
For a printed transcript of this or any Frontline program, please write to this address.
This is LPB.
In the watery wilderness of inner space at a crushing depth of more than 300 feet, for nearly a month, these divers face a lonely test of human survival. The legendary Jacques Cousteau has masterminded a fascinating mission into this cold and silent world. Experience the discoveries of Conch Shell 3 in The World of Jacques Cousteau on the best of National Geographic.
Saturday night at 7 on LPB.
Public television is television for the 90s. Be a part of the excitement of public TV.
You can run, but you can't hide. And no matter how strong you are, the enemy is stronger. This is what life is like for the elephants of Tsavo. They're no match for the firepower of poachers. But there is hope. Kenya's rangers and conservationists are fighting back. And with their help, the elephants of Tsavo may still be here for our children. See them next time on Nature.
On member-supported LPB, Sunday night at 7.
They came, they saw, and they laughed. And pretty soon, America's sense of humor was Jewish. And now we're going to explore this full, rich, funny world with our favorite funny people. And I'd love to tell you more, but the title's too long. Next time, dear God, please choose someone else. The legend of Jewish humor.
What right do you have to bother me with titles for your show?
Next time, dear God, on Great Performances. And you don't have to...
Monday night at 8:30 on your LPB station. This is LPB, TV worth watching.
Some people hustle pool, some people hustle cars. But have you ever heard about the man who hustles stars? Jack Horkheimer, star hustler. Director of the Miami Space Transit Planetarium.
Our episode for this week, Monday, February 25th through Sunday, March 1st, is Celebrate Sirius Day, March 1st, 1991.
And now here to tell you all about tonight's sky and the biggest show of all, the universe, your star hustler, Jack Horkheimer.
Greetings, greetings, fellow stargazers, and quick, right off the top of your head, what is the name of the brightest star in the heavens? And to which constellation does it belong? Here's a hint. Woof, woof. Second hint, the sun doesn't count. Now, if you said Sirius, the dog star, the eye of the star pattern, the greater dog, you're absolutely correct. And every March 1st, just like clockwork, Sirius culminates at 9 p.m. But don't let that word culminate throw you, because it means the same thing in astronomy as it means to a mountain climber. As the dictionary says, to culminate means to reach the highest point or degree, the top or the summit. So at 9 p.m. your local time on March 1st, Sirius will reach its highest point above the horizon, and it will be precisely due south. So I would like to propose that since we call April 1st April Fool's Day and May 1st May Day, from now on, let's call March 1st Sirius Day, on which day everyone will go outside at 9 p.m. their local time and look due south for the culmination of Sirius, for the express purpose of taking a specific moment in time to contemplate the wonderful and incredible nature of the universe. For Sirius is the perfect focal point for showing us how truly magnificent the universe really is. And as you look at Sirius this March 1st, think of this. Sirius looks like the brightest star in the heavens to us here on planet Earth only because it is so close to us, only 9 light years away. There are many stars intrinsically much brighter, but much, much farther away. Even so, Sirius is about 23 times more luminous than our own sun. But in addition to being the brightest star visible, Sirius is special for other reasons, for it is a double star with a history that changed the course of astronomy. In fact, its companion star was discovered mathematically 30 years before it was even seen. You see, back in 1834, observations of the way Sirius wiggled convinced mathematician-astronomer Friedrich Bessel that Sirius was being disturbed by some other massive body close to it. And by using Kepler's astronomical laws of motion, Bessel was actually able to calculate the mass and distance of the suspected companion star. And such a star should have been bright enough to be seen through telescopes of that day. Strangely, however, no one could find the star until 30 years later when a better telescope was designed. And the dog star's newly found companion was affectionately named the Pup. But it took another 50 years until new technology revealed the true nature of the companion star and it shook the foundations of astronomy. For the Pup star turned out to be only 3 times the diameter of our Earth. But even more bizarre, it had the same mass as our sun, 300,000 times the mass of our planet Earth. Which simply means that the stuff of which this star is made is so super compacted together that 1 pint of its material would weigh 1,000 tons on Earth. That's one heck of a puppy, if you ask me. So, out under the night sky with you at 9 p.m. every March 1st, face due south and watch the dog star and his prodigious pup culminate in the cosmos. And it's simple if you just keep looking up.
Star Hustler is made possible by the P.L. Dodge Foundation, the Abraham Schwartz Estate, the Rosenberg Foundation, and the patrons of the Miami Museum of Science and Space Transit Planetarium.
This is LPB. This is KLTM-TV 13 Monroe, a broadcast service of Louisiana Educational Television Authority. KLTM-TV operates on VHF Channel 13, 210 to 216 megahertz, with an effective radiated power of 316,000 watts visual and 31,600 watts oral, as authorized by the Federal Communications Commission. Our telecommunications center is located at 7860 Anselmo Lane, Baton Rouge. Our transmitter facilities are located 2.5 miles north of Riverton. KLTM-TV 13 Monroe is affiliated with PBS, the Public Broadcasting Service.